Memory heap is an important part of JS Engine's memory architecture. Hi, I'm Rohan, and this video is part of a series of videos where we are exploring how JS manages its memory in depth. So let's get to it. What is memory heap? The memory heap is a segment of our memory that is used to store objects and functions. This is used to store dynamic data. By dynamic data, I mean that any data whose size is unknown unless we execute it and the memory needs to be allocated at runtime, that is dynamic data. This is the biggest section of our memory, which is responsible for allocating memory to objects and functions. The JS engine utilizes this memory by reading from and writing to variables in memory stack that has references to this part of the memory in the memory heap, and then finally releasing or deallocating this part of the memory when it is no longer needed, so it can be used for other purposes. This process of deallocating unneeded memory is handled by garbage collectors, which we will discuss in a moment. In V8, the heap is further divided into various spaces. Those are new space, old space, large object space, code space, and three other spaces known as cell space, property cell space, and map space. What is new space? New space is where newly created objects are allocated memory. This is where they are stored, and many of these objects have a shorter lifespan. It is designed to store short-lived objects that are much more likely to be garbage collected, and it is a smaller region of heap compared to old space. This space consists of two semi-spaces, from space and to space. From space is where objects are allocated memory, and to space is mostly left alone. It only comes into play during garbage collection. The primary garbage collector that works here is known as scavenger, also known as minor garbage collector. The objects within from space are referred to as young generation objects, which can further be categorized into nursery objects, which refers to newly created objects that have been allocated memory here, and intermediate objects, which refers to young generation's objects that have survived a single garbage collection cycle and have been promoted from nursery to intermediate. Now, if these intermediate objects survive a second garbage collection cycle, then these are promoted as old generation objects and are moved to old space. Next, let's talk about old space. Old space, also referred to as old generation, is where those objects that have a longer lifespan are stored, which means that these are the objects that have survived two minor garbage collection cycle in new space and then have been moved here. The old space is typically much larger than the new space. This is because the old space needs to accommodate a larger number of objects that have a relatively longer lifespan. The old space can further be divided into two sections. The first section is called old pointer space. This contains objects that have still survived and hold pointers to other objects. The second section is called old data space. This section stores objects that only contain raw data and do not hold any pointers to any other objects or methods. By managing the old space separately, the JavaScript engine can optimize the handling of long-lived objects, ensuring a much more efficient memory usage and smoother application performance. The management of this space is overseen by the major garbage collector, specifically the mark sweep and mark compact process, which we will discuss in a few moments. Next is large object space. This is a part of heap memory that is specifically used to store large objects. There is a size threshold for objects. If an object is larger than this threshold, then it is created and allocated memory directly in the large object space as compared to regular objects, which are allocated in the new space and then move to old space when they survive two minor garbage collection cycles. Instead, these large objects are created in this space. When these objects are no longer needed, then this part of the memory is deallocated and released. Next is the code space. The code space is where compiled blocks of our JavaScript code is stored. When our JS code is executed, then it is passed into an abstract syntax tree, which is then interpreted into bytecode and then finally compiled into native executable code. This executable code is stored in the code space. And this is the only space in the heap with executable memory. There are three other spaces: cell space, property cell space, and map space. The cell space contains cell objects. A cell is a type of fixed size object that is used by V8 internally to store small amounts of data. The property cell space contains property cell objects. A property cell is used to store property metadata for JavaScript objects and are of fixed size. Map space contains map objects. The map objects are internally used by V8 to store the shape of JavaScript objects. This includes prototype chain and the attributes of their properties. All objects in these three spaces are of the same size, which simplifies the garbage collection process. I do not know how accurate the info regarding these three spaces are, so please feel free to correct me in the comments. So, to summarize, we have discussed heap memory. What are the different heap spaces and how they are used to store different types of dynamic data? Its allocation, deallocation, and access by the JS engine during the execution of our code. I also want to discuss minor and major garbage collections. So this is what we are discussing in the next video. Its importance and how they are not only used to deallocate memory, but also to help manage the memory heap better. Thank you for your time. Have a nice day. Namaskar.